about your horse's warm-up and how to do a warm-up where you can evaluate flowing movement, you can evaluate stuck movement, and do this with purpose, a strategy, power, and ease. And so wouldn't it be amazing to create like a horse and rider team where both of you are giving back and forth willingly to each other and consistently, which would cause a never-ending cascade of exciting progress and results? Wouldn't that be amazing? Well, we can do that with this warm-up that I'm going to describe to you, called the strategic warm-up. It's a simple three-step process. And the purpose of it is to connect our spines to our horse's spines to facilitate self-carriage and balance. If you have those things with your horse, then you are much more likely to get amazing results, and you're much more likely not to have injuries, both for yourself as a rider and for your horse. Have you ever been taught a lesson like this? This was many years ago, and I had my Morgan mare. She's actually 31 right now, out there in the pasture with no teeth, eating grass. She was a very anxious and nervous horse, and this was my concern. I didn't know why she was so anxious and so nervous whenever I tried to take up contact to warm up and then to proceed to my ride. A lesson that I could have, and it was a pair of coaches who worked together. So I hauled my horse to their outdoor, and we went into the lesson, and first I had one of the coaches, and she said, okay, we're going to warm up our horse. I was mounted on my horse, and we proceeded to do the things that she told us to do, right? And she was looking, and she was seeing what we were doing, and my horse was chomping on the bit constantly, and she was rushing constantly, and she was falling around, and she was nervous, and she was anxious, and it kept getting worse and worse. We went through this part of the lesson, which was half of the lesson, with this coach, and then we went to the next coach, and she said, okay, now you can go over to my partner, and she's going to sculpt you in the saddle. She placed my legs, how they had to be placed on the saddle, and how they had to look, and how I had to hold them. And then she put my back in place, and then she put my arms in place, and she said, this is how you get contact. We did that for about half an hour, and my horse, again, was not any less anxious. She was not any more feeling comfortable with herself or what we were doing. We left the lesson, and we hauled our horse out, and that experience changed the way I looked at horses for the rest of my life. So here were my conclusions that I got from that lesson. Number one was that no one likes to have an obedience lesson, right? Including horses. Pushy and aggressive or awkward even techniques that are given to you in a lesson, and maybe you can resonate with this, it just basically turns riders and horses off. So that's one of the big don'ts with the warm-up, is that you can't have a hidden agenda, which leads me to my next point. There's no cookie cutter rider position. There's no cookie cutter horse position that is effective. Sure, you can do that, but it's not going to be effective for you. Our actual needs in that lesson were not addressed. They were never addressed, and they were never even inquired about. My horse wasn't looked at as to what was going on, and neither was I, and we were not treated like an individual pair. It was just, this is the way the lesson, this is the way we sculpt you, this is the way we sculpt every rider in the saddle, and so this is what we're gonna do. And the third thing is that those coaches didn't create any curiosity or desire in me as a rider or in my horse. So there was nothing about that warm-up that made me or my horse want to ask for more information, more questions, what was next, what should happen next. And we both had no desire to take it further. This type of warm-up, when these things are not considered in the warm-up, will not lead to a better partnership or better results. If you would like the PDF of my strategic warm-up, I'm going to go into it briefly here. And this is the document that is in our program only. This is the only place you can get it. But if you'd like it, then put warm-up in the notes for me below and I'll make sure that it gets sent to you. So this is how we do it in our strategic warm-up. This is what we do instead. We have a process that gets you as a rider in contact with your spine, and then your spine, you become in contact with your horse's spine. So we show you how to actually move together with your horse, starting on the ground and then in the saddle, how to move together, how to sort out the stuck places and the flowing places in both your body and your horse's body. And from there, you can start to problem solve. So in the lesson that I described earlier, I had no capability to problem solve on my own. Was my horse warmed up? I don't know. We went through our paces and I was sculpted in the saddle, but I was just put into a position. I wasn't warmed up. I did not have the capability to solve problems as they arose after the warm-up, which is the key point of the warm-up. And the process also helps you to get in tune with your body, your horse's body, because when you're happy physically in your body, then you're more than likely happy in your mind and your emotions, right? There's lots of things going on, and we address these all in my program. But the body is so important to be warmed up in an effective way. There is the right way to do this and the not so right way to do this. Your horse is happy in their mind and their emotions more than likely when they're happy in their body. Of course, there can be things that happen like a major spook or something that distracts your horse. But generally speaking, that's the case. And also, when you have this type of strategic warm-up, that you're making sure that your horse does have the synovial fluid moving within the joints and the whole their body is starting to really warm up and move in an effective, functional way, then you're much more able to prevent injuries as a rider and for your horse. I just want to outline for you what is in my strategic warm-up. Number one is we walk with our horses and we feel into the feeling that we have in our hands and our bodies through our spine. Okay, so what is the feeling that we are receiving? Then we're able to evaluate that and we're able to know how to respond. The second part is that we get very specific on areas of the spine of your horse's body. What parts are moving effectively? Which parts are moving dysfunctionally? Which parts do we need to put attention to and in what way? And the third part is that we assist and we guide the horse to find new and favorable movement patterns. So yes, we're going to find dysfunctional movement patterns within our horses and within ourselves. But what do we do about it? That's what we do. That's how we warm up our horse, because you never know what happened out in the pasture with their herd mate. So this is a way of warming up, of evaluating, of problem solving, of knowing what to do next, and working always towards effective, functional movement patterns for both the rider and horse. And this is how you create a rider and horse team that can go to any limit that you would like to go, any goal, any desire that you have. If you would like this PDF of my warm-up, just put warm-up as a note for me below and I'll make sure you get it. And thanks so much for being here.